Here's Pastor Tim Polley with the First Christian Church in Benton.
In Romans 12, verses 1 through 2, the Apostle Paul states, "I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect." Well, good morning, friends. What is the difference between being and doing? This is the question that most of us have asked ourselves at one time or another. Are we okay with the status quo? Or do we feel that God is calling us to new and different expectations in our lives? In an attempt to answer these questions, we often attempt to vision and dream about what God desires for us and His kingdom. Well, the Apostle Paul tells us that to vision, we must understand what God has done for us and what the Spirit is at work doing for us. Understanding that we are a creation that God is constantly working on is the key to understanding that the status quo does not exist in those that are created by God. One of the definitions of vision is the act or power of anticipating that which will or may come to be. But the key to visioning is understanding how God's visions for us are received. Brothers and sisters, as we seek God's wisdom in transforming our lives, we must understand that these visions can only be received by having a heart that is open to them. Discerning God's will for our lives can only occur through open communication with the Father. We of faith have been taught that this communication is done through prayer and relationship to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Beloved, my prayer for you this day is that you open your hearts and minds to the visions that God has for our lives. Embrace the fact that the Spirit is at work in you and in all of us that are a work in progress. God truly has a vision for our lives. Go to Him in prayer and open your hearts and minds to the true vision that God casts for all of His children.
This message from the First Christian Church on South Main Street in Benton has been brought